Hawks pod, and of course, I know Gideon's extra happy because this is his map. He loves this map for some reason. Chuchu, why?
Because Explain. It's just a lot of land and nobody's torturing themselves swimming.
90% land! Yeah, boy!
There you go. He's not a swimmer boy.
Hey, I am. I actually...
Do you even swim?
Yeah, I teach swimming, actually.
Wait,
wow.
Fun fact.
Wait, what?
Wow.
Yeah, I have a certification to teach swimming. But enough about me. Let's get into Miramar. Let's see the flight path. It seems... honestly, this is actually a pretty neutral path. And I think, Chuchu, once again, every time you mention, like, I want Miramar, I want a neutral path, it seems to be giving it to you on Miramar.
Yeah, they love me more than you guys.
Shots fired. Ooh. My feelings.
Yeah, don't get it too hard. But back into the game. Hey, Los Leones Impala will be occupied by some teams. Also, El Azhar, we do know, thanks to our observer just now, it's been a long day for you guys.
Yep, absolutely. And this flight path is just cutting across. It's 100% land there. I'll be interested to see who really wants to go onto Los Higos, that sort of area. Take that little bit of risk, but then again, the flight path is just one thing. What is more important is where the circle will be. Will the circle just want to tease? I still want to see that water circle. Like, bring it on, Los Higos, come on.
Keep hoping, boy, keep hoping. I'm eyeing the door the moment that happens, but looking at where the team's going, a lot of them managed to go to the north sides. Oh! Boom! 100% land in the circle.
I was about to hold you for that on the door, but okay, you got away this time.
Yes. It's a beautiful one. A straight cutting into the circle for the flight path too. So those who exit on the north will be super happy, especially I think RV is on top of El Azhar.
I don't know how, even though it is beneficial for North, we have seen teams play out of circle in Miramar decently well, This is in Sandhawk where a lot of these teams that we saw as a pattern, B and C, in groups B and C, they want to play for inner circle. Miramar, I think you can kind of do a bit of both here.
Oh, and I'm glad to see Voki actually has some looting time this time as compared to the previous map.
You know. I asked him just now, what were you doing when you straight into the lobby back when you start the game? And I just look at Yakuza, I like lick him a bit, like, you know, because I can just lick it. I went, what? What were you doing? That they are actually sitting across Yakuza's team, which is VIP. So he literally just talked everybody else's faces.
Yeah, I know Kuza's really attractive, but okay, all right. let's not start the stalker thing here. It's just the first week, guys. Let's calm down.
All right. Let's look at how this is going. Oh, no. Are they going to...
Wait.
He's going to go for another roadkill.
No.
It's going to be another roadkill here.
Wait, what? I'm not just going in circles. One para just behind the stone. What is that? They are not even going. They're just going in circles. They can't even pin it down. Oh man, Ideal, you're not letting it go. You're like, that's Manparang there. We gotta get him, dude. Oh, no weapons at all. No fist fight been taken. And oh, it looks like the cavalry is coming. Rico's like, oh, Manparang. Now he's in trouble now. 50% more. One more knock and he's back to the lobby. Manparang still need to hang on. And now Ideal just calling the cavalry. Yo, oh my goodness, Ideal. Wait, from the other side, we do see Manparang gonna finish it off. Manparang.
Oh man,
we were about to go ballistic there. Manpara gonna finish this off with a fist fight.
I feel really, I don't feel good about the kill, yes, but I do want to see Yudu play from behind, as now the shots are being shot into Ideal. He's trying to get on out of there. Steel Hearts do make it out with the free initial kill. Yudu now have to play from behind. With a one-man disadvantage.
That was, you know, it took him so long for Steel Hearts to just run him down. It's a nice joke by Manpara. You have to give the respect there.
I mean, it was a slow car.
That's one thing, but yet they literally took two men to fight against one Manpara without anything on him.
Oh boy.
Oh my goodness, man. Back to EVOS. They are actually just leading face again. So they lost their captain Manpara for Yudu game, but will that make any disadvantage for this team?
I mean, honestly, considering who are the top fraggers, let's see how much this is going to impact them, because now that they don't have their shot collar, well, I mean, they still technically do have their shot collar. Let's see how much of a difference it's going to make when they are one man down.
Absolutely. This will probably change a little bit. it, because I think this is the first time that we do see Yudogan actually losing a team member so early on. They normally, like how we talked about the previous map, how they lasted so long up to the final few circles with their full team intact, full weapons, guns blazing everywhere, but this is definitely going to change their direction.
That's true. And looking into Picado right now, Boss Way, they are not contested, but those actually on the south will have to cross both way if they want to go into the safe zone. But apparently, they might want to migrate into up to the graveyard where the resurgence are at the current beam.
Well, it is the first circle, so technically, you know, I wouldn't expect too much here and such bigger rotations just yet. But again, the loot is going to be more valuable than anything else within this phase, because again, level 3 body armor is pretty much going to trump everybody else when it comes to a gunfight.
Yeah, this is a totally different when it comes to stats, sorry, on the left side here. A little bit, I think that's half of what they have on the stats that with most kill for Yudogan and EVOS VIP. We saw how much damage they have, 4 digits at that. And this is a totally different level when it comes to just 600 damage with 5 kills.
Excuse me, what are you trying to say here there?
Maybe he kills still people.
Dirty, dirty kill stealers ruining my games once more.
We saw that before, and what you're talking about this game now.
Yeah, and now we do see that RSG looks like, moving over to Iron Pro to Small Boy. They're just scouting out all the areas. Small Boy here having this really, really high ground. I'm just getting those jitters. Oh, and
wait,
oh,
there's a pack kill. When did that happen?
Oh, we missed that.
I'm sad.
Oh, man.
We're sad.
I'm sad.
We're all sad. But the punch kill, we didn't miss that one. That's important as well.
But we have a pan kill.
Oh, yeah. At least one now.
One's on the board. One's on the board. Just laying.
Yeah, we're happy. But back in the junkyard, from the graveyard to up to the junkyard, they are moving a bit north for resurgence. They're not doing great for the past few games. They dropped themselves into the second.
Oh, boo! Boo!
Oh, you got trolled!
No! Why you gotta do this to me, production? Oh, I feel terrible now. There is no pan kill, unfortunately. Guess it was a miscount this time.
Oh, man.
It's like they gave you the candy and then they take it away from you.
Yeah. It's like halfway down my mouth and they're like, yoink! That's how much I could taste that pan kill.
Yeah, we're all sad. But back to the game, guys.
Back to the game, of course. Now we do see... I'm so sorry. I'm still in the middle of the pan kill. I'm just waiting for that. And we do see a Pamburu right here. Together with Bravo. Looks like Pamburu will need to go down. Blue circle is not in their favor. And oh, looks like Wixos will go down. How will take him down there? And they will secure this location. It is still the first circle, so they can still tank it out, loot whatever they need, and get to safety.
Yeah, and it looks like they did get an explosion. What is this kill feed? What happened over there? I need to know who died in that explosion.
Still
what
Hearts.
Happened?
Still Hearts will fight it against ESG, if I'm not mistaken. And that's a lot of vehicle explosion in this game. I think we might just have a 4-digit explosion of vehicles only throughout the whole tournament. Maybe make it like 10,000 ones, and there you go. No recall, Stewart making sure that he sprays, but none of them is actually connected and not clipped at all, because well, there you go, at least you got a vehicle out of that.
Yeah. You got one more there.
I mean, it still means it's going to be a difficult disengage, because now they're going to be looking for more vehicles at this point in time, just in case they come to a situation where they need to create a barrier or some form of cover in open spaces.
Yep, and we do see his Stewart 9k. Looks like he sent his teammates just across there. Stewart 9k just way behind, but he has a vehicle with him. He will definitely join it up, but ooh, looks like another team is just moving it on really, really close right now. EVOS VIP. Oh yeah, GeekFam was really close, and now we...
You get me now, right? That's like a real kill there. With 4 digits and just now 5 kills with 600. You know he just kills still that way. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I still love you guys no matter what. But yeah, that's kind of apparent there. But back into EVOS VIP, the last chicken dinner team. They are rotating a bit late.
What do you have? I'm giving you the stinky eye here. Only because it's like, that just could mean that he's not securing those kills, but putting in a lot of damage. Just saying.
Maybe.
Yeah. Okay. We could debate about this till tomorrow. But then again, just looking at this action right here, well, maybe action, because team number 21 and team number 24, they are really close by, but Well, it is still the second circle. Maybe they won't engage with each other. Lorenzo now with a very expensive car that a recent streamer just bought. Looks like he's just going round and round here.
Check his footwear.
I just hope that nobody shot him in the vehicle. And Kick on the other side, also with all four wheels, making sure they have a rotation super fast from one compound jumping to another, just to loot out everything. He got quite a decent amount of gear, all level 3, most of them.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised that they were so good. The area that they went to was so good to them. Not to mention that they also have the convoys as well. The vehicles as well to kind of convoy around. And this is going to put a lot of pressure on anybody who's nearby, especially if you are Steelhearts where you only have a member out there by himself.
He really plays a little bit sneaky. He's like, I got the information, I have to go out now. That kind of impression when he just hops into his Dacia and drive away. The moment he saw foreman of Boss Wei, who just managed to show themselves on top of a mountain of a water treatment here.
Oh, and I just saw the Cupid there. It looks like Pingu, he will be knocked down. It looks like H2O now, they are being rampaged on, and Bapa are securing their position. And oh, Abad, you just got another kill. Are still survived there at the distance. Will they go for that kill? But looks like what's for sure, they cannot save their teammate at this point.
I don't know why, but I feel like Cloud jinxed this team. Every single time when he shout casting is his team H2O and they're being pinned down. I know they are a great team, Cloud, but stop jinxing the team.
No, I'm not, but then again, please, Bapa. Bapa, it looks like they are going for it.
It's backing.
You are just behind the terrain. They are going for it. Just behind the tree. Oh, Arts, I'm not sure how you're going to survive this, really. It looks like Six is going. They're going to go flanking from both sides. They are breaking up right now. And Arts is just buying time. Hopefully, some other team starts dying. But
no.
Unfortunately, from the side, Six will take out Arts. Bapa, Arts, Six still maintain his dignity there.
That's the first team out for today. Sorry you have to shoutcast that one, Cloud, but yeah, that's the first team that will be placed on 16 H2O straight into the lobby back again.
Oh, that's gotta hurt a little bit inside, but luckily Bapa did actually have the level 3 body armor, which made a significant difference because he actually got hit first rather than, you know, initiating when he saw the peak.
But you have to agree, right, what I said just now?
You know what? I don't want to be part of this caster because I'm really scared of Caster.
What we need to agree right now is that Grim is in trouble there and his teammates are in the house. Grim is just outside there. Somebody needs to go and save him. And now Grim, he is in trouble. Oh, and now Grim will be knocked down, but he's just outside. They can't go and save him. The moment they go there, RSG is just all around. They do have multiple angles here, and we do see here Small Boy coming in with the vehicle, and now they are surrounding. Oh no, FV is now not in a good position.
Yeah, they are being cornered by Team Resurgence, who got all four men up with the rest of FV quite in a predicament. Look at that, they have one man knocked, but there's no way for them to actually revive him.
Yeah, Grim is just really out of position at this point in time, and unfortunately RSG did spot out Grim of all people rather than, you know, the entirety of Flash Vision in that building. They've taken out the vehicles and now they just have to convoy around. They hear Bapa coming by and it's like, no, this is bad. If we're caught out in the open, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. Iron Pro gets into his own vehicle and they start moving out.
Yep, you absolutely don't want to get trapped in a love triangle there, just like my previous relationship. But then again, yeah, okay, all right, I'll save that story for later. But then again, being objective of the game, you don't want to be stuck in that love triangle because the moment you kill one, someone can come from behind and take you out. So you just want to get away from there.
Oh, yeah, then now back to Hacienda. Resurgence is going to pick a fight on Bapa, who just wiped H2O just now. Quite in terms of economy-wise, they are not really looted up just yet and lost too many, if I'm not mistaken. But Small Boy tossed straight away, trying to revert his direction on the other hand and kind of trying to rotate the other way, get the flanks too. That's pretty smart.
It is. It really is. Both teams, you know, the only difference is the numbers game here because RSG need to take out by Trinity here. Trix, and then look to control that area and completely isolate Bapa here.
And Trix, of course, with the grenades, go out. They are head-to-head with each other at this point. Looks like Trix will just go up and down, trying to find that angle here. But then again, in the house, we do see here Iron Pro, just beside the house, probably trying to do a flank there for trying to find that angle. Small boy just moving left and right. Ooh, oh, did you see each other there? Small boy going round and round, but can he get it? No! Small boy will go down there, ladies and gentlemen. Now we have six! Six takes out another one. They are wiping RSG back into the lobby.
RSG was trying to play Baba against their own game, but now they have to delay that for now. Voki, make sure that they are on a retreat because there's one more team left. At 15 place.
This is bad. This is so bad. Even though Epi is out, a Resurgence are in a position. It's still a phase. It is a phase 3 circle. It's gonna hurt a little bit. He can heal himself up, get into the vehicle, and start moving out. But it's still a little too difficult as the rest of the team of Dingoes is making sure that Baba can't even move forward.
And now Trix is just locked down. He only has a terrain to help him. Dingoes, Marcel just moving in, but he is all alone in this area. Oh, he has his teammates just behind him, but he's fronting it right now. Grenades all goes out left and right. Baba just don't know how to counter that. They may not have enough utilities. Now it looks like the grenades are going out one by one. Or they're just pressing them back, not giving them the opportunity to show themselves.
Yup, and that is Maisel we're talking about. He's not giving any room of a breather for Baba'a at all. And they are really down in terms of economy. We've seen how many teams they have taken apart. And Brada, just now from Team Bosku, is also fighting against Resurgence at the same time.
But look at the position of Nook right now. He quickly goes into his vehicle and looks for a higher ground position to kind of have even footing with Baba, but also look at the flank angle. The rest of the team sees what's going on. The circle is going to be closing in soon. This isn't the fight they want to take, but they've hurt Baba enough for them to be satisfied.
Yes, absolutely. Looks like their escape plan is now being deployed. They will get away into this circle, try to get as close as possible. But look at this. Look at this. Lots of teams. And oh, RSG right now still in the blue circle on the right side of the map right here. And now they really need to go there. But there are a lot of gatekeepers and a lot of people on the way as well.
Man, those who are actually from the east side of the circle will really have a hard time. Baba, I suppose they've been shushed out by Dingoes out of the zone. And look at this. They are trying to give off the impression and tell the other team of Expert and Y, if I'm not mistaken just now, to just go away. But at the same time, Dingoes, they are really down in terms of utilities.
Oh no, I think they just heard Baba go, oh, deploy, and now they have to get back, go run in straight into the ground, take cover, because Baba is here with the frontal assault. One, Mace takes on one, he takes down two, there's two more left, but he's hiding behind cover. He finally, can he take down three? No, he doesn't. He trades one, but Nook needs to hold his ground here. Jerry and Barn gets it from the side. Baba survive, one squad wipe.
Again, Baba surviving this onslaught here. Just now, RSG now in another one. They are just hanging on to this. They are showing that they are survivors at this round. And here goes revives and resets going out left and right.
After one, then another one, and you got another. You know that puns, right? But back to the game. Last survival again. They always show themselves in the map, but they just don't seem to get the right time, right position, and get the kills done. They always be the one who being ambushed by the other team, which you do right now. They lost one man straight into the game on Parang, but they don't have the captain, but enough with the information they had around them to actually hold their ground.
I think most importantly here is, you know, moving up to the high ground. They've got the vehicles to start setting up cover here, but high ground is going to be highly contested for both of these teams. So Claude, I mean, what can they do if you're in this position?
Oh, this is going to be very difficult. The only thing that you can do is like try to hold on to it. They have a couple of trees there that they can, but how long can they hold on? This is the question mark. Oh, looks like the grenade goes out. Drag just throw a grenade and just get back there. They definitely know that Yudu is at the top there. It's not going to be easy to snipe them just because of the terrain. Just look at this. Jumper just doing what he does best, going in and out of the terrain, making use of it.
Bossway just placed a little bit smoke there. At the same time, we have ESG trying to merge himself from the low ground to the higher one. Yudu is conquering on top of a mountain for now. This is quite similar to how Secret played yesterday.
What? actually, you're right. It is quite a mirror, actually, because Secret was trying to hold upper ground for the most part. But however, the circle is sort of favoring Yudogang, but it might not in the next 22 seconds. It's next. ESG is moving in, taking out, trying to take out another squad. Axe is in trouble. They get in close quarters, and he does win out that engagement.
ESG, how just now was fighting against three people with the lowest HP possible, rushed right in, wiped them out solo handedly.
But looks like it could be their turn now, because Pamburu and we do see here how as well, they are very, very low here. They need to do something. Energy drink goes out there, smoke goes out as well, but that smoke also let their enemies know that yes, they are all in this small hut. Do they want to go for the rush? This is the question mark here. Drax and the rest of Yudu still holding on to this high ground here, looking at all the action from the top there, just letting everyone fighting themselves out.
Right now Yudogang is in a perfect prime position, because even though the circle, once it closes down, their backs are absolutely clear, and then they can start looking for those frags really, really quick. But Expert is going to be back into the lobby this time. Unfortunately, ESG still holding on to their guns. Team No Recoil would like to engage onto ESG, but they are just completely pinned down.
Yeah, at the same time, Last Survival is trying to get off Geek Fam from the map. Oh, look at that. They managed to get impunity for Geek Fam just now with a couple of nades, while Last Survival is actually telling them down. Look at that 4-2-0. They are taking advantage as third party here. We're speaking of Last Survival, who has been very quiet.
Oh, 4-2-0, you better get away there. You gotta reset yourselves, Geek Fam. Now just look at this. Everyone's just holding on to high ground. High ground wins in this, ladies and gentlemen. And we do see here, Yudu, they are just hanging on to this. They are just doing the same thing. Oh, the circle is really in their favor. And just look at this mountain. They are just trying to climb on top of each other. We do see their Last Survivor together with Yudu. They are on a similar path there on the mountain, just holding out as long as possible. Ainoki trying to get the shot, but this is what I said earlier, ladies and gentlemen, because they are so high up there, Geek Fam can't get a shot on.
Yeah, and worst of all, they can't even use utility. Only smokes is going to give them some kind of protection. They can't get the nades up there, it's way too high up. And now they've got a couple of vehicles, but they're really scared of getting shot down by multiple teams, because again, it's still closing in. Once that circle comes in, I want to see where the next circle. Oh no! It's Yudu's luck!
It's actually favoring them a lot. They don't have to even climb down from that top of a mountain, while Bappa is silently creeping up behind. We do have Steel Hearts, who is also doing the same thing, tailing Bappa up from their flanks as well as their rear backs. While we're looking at Dawn, the other side of the map here, ESG fighting against Team No Recoil straight head on. And they are taking advantage as Jumper just sniping one by one out.
Yes, Jumper trying to take that advantage indeed, and we do see here Team No Recoil. Oh, just beside there, Team No Recoil goes in. There's still two more inside the hub. Will they be able to make it? And they go round and round. Sidney sprays some shots. Sidney now is very, very low. He will need to heal up Steward as well before they can go back in again. And now Sidney uses the first aid kit. They better be quick right now, because the rest of ESG is just inside. Anything can happen at this moment. Sidney tries to get a sneaky shot from the window, but it does not connect. Steward may just go in here, and he can actually do the rushes. Smokes out, he can actually do the rushes. And yes! Rush goes in, but then again, Steelwood being rushed by, but Sinmi is there to back him up, and they will go with the revive.
They're able to pull this one. Oh wait, Molotov all of a sudden thrown down. You know what's really impressive the entire time? They have smokes, but if they had a nade, it would have saved them a whole lot of time to flush them out. But however, they are out of nades, and all they got was smokes.
Yeah, yes, you were sitting ducks just now. There's nowhere for them to take in a very close compound. Nowhere to go, and the rest of Team Geeks is also behind them. We're looking at Yudu is just abusing this high ground terrain. They are having a great time.
Yeah, this is just unfair for Yudu there, but at the same time, looks like Yudu is moving away from that location. They really need to get within that circle first, because it's just so small right now. Try to get those strategic locations, and we do see a right in smack in the middle of the map. There's still no one there. Everyone's just moving cautiously. Smokes goes out from Yudu, and we do see Drax here from a very far location, but Drax looks like he's in trouble there. He will go down definitely to the play zone. And now Damroot and the rest of Geek Fam, they are just looking in from a different angle, trying to hang on to their safe zone location.
considering how Yudu was down a member very early on, this is pretty impressive that they're able to pull it back and also rack up some kills. Two of their members on the almost the highest peak in this map right now. It's kind of a struggle, but the first grenade kill coming in from Aoki as Gifam continue to start pushing up here. Chuchu, what can they do to really reclaim that position?
It's just Yudu's game this time because the circle really favors them. You have to climb up to the top of the mountain, but there are so many few places that you can hide yourself into. And the places that you're hiding is really not in your favor as well. Look at that jumper. Yes, he get punished, but there is so easy for him to get onto his ground straight away.
Yes, and we do see here, Yudu here, they're trying to hold him to another position, but I like Geek's position better just because of those trees like Chuchu mentioned as well. And now jumper, looks like the grenade will go out here. Jumper now being the NBA All-Star, everything goes out. This is the moment. This is the sixth circle, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. Jenny goes down in the process. Looks like Damroot gets a kill out there, and Jumper takes out Heox in the process. Jumper just taking advantage of this. This is unfair. Heox now is just behind the tree, can't do much. His teammates need to save him, but it's just too far away.
I mean, at this point, they gotta play the numbers game. It's gonna be tough because it's now just Jumper and Fredo right here. Jumper, it's the signature. He goes into the vehicle to reposition. Remember, Boskru is still in it to win it. He's just hiding it out for as long as possible. They still have members there, but Geek Fam now need to deal with the problem at hand. They don't have the advantage in terms of height. However, they have numbers, so they have to peek them at about the same time in order to divert attention and maybe get a frag.
And that's true, but at the same time, Yudu's position is so easily getting the tunnels for Geek Fam here. Well, like you said, Boss Way Palex, it's just being nastily.
Oh, no, he's getting those kills there, left and right. This is being so nasty, ladies and gentlemen. Palace, he deserves a standing ovation just for that. Now it is just him and also 4-2 all around. Oh, Palace! Palace, you almost got it there.
He just has to butt in. And that's the perfect moment where he just get double kill with a double mate and just make everything miserable for everybody else.
I'm pretty sure Yudu is happy with the performance. Unfortunately, the one sleeper agent. Yeah.
They forgot one more person.
Oh, the sleeper agent just holding his ground, lobs the grenades, actually nails them right on the head. Absolutely perfect. Because again, Jumper was pushing forward so that Fredo could go for the Overwatch here, and it was really smart because Team Boskru, they identified, okay, Fredo needs to go down first, and then Jumper is going to be easy pick.